Okay, well, it's been a pleasure and a great fascination for me to be reading these poems for the Cape Farewell challenge. The first thing I'd want to say is, of course, it's very difficult to make good art about anything. I think it's particularly hard to make art or good art about climate change. And I think on top of that, it's even harder, it's the hardest of all to make good literature out of climate change. A sculptor can do something with ice, and somehow that has an intellectual and sensual resonance that's immediate and doesn't need a great deal of explaining. Literature pins you down. Words carry meanings, and you've got to tie yourself to those meanings. And the second point would be, I think that it's difficult because it's hard to write poetry out of themes. It's tough. And I think the pleasure for me of reading these poems is partly to see how they've dealt with these problems. If one thinks of climate change, one is in a world of themes, whereas what we want from poetry initially is a detailed rhythm, the beauty of language itself. It reminded me in reading these poems of the difficulty I faced myself when I was writing Solar. If you make literature out of climate change, you run the danger of falling into one long lament, of tying yourself down in a form of droning pessimism, or you're full of bright-eyed celebration of what's there and what we've got to keep. A course has to be steered between these. I chose the route of a kind of satire of human nature. And that's not so easy within a short poem. What really struck me, and I have to say the section that gave me the most pleasure simply because it was tied to detail, was the wonderful idea and the wonderful response to the notion of what we would send of ourselves in a box to give a message, as it were, of who we are, what we've been doing, and what our history is to an alien intelligence, to an alien civilization. All I can say is that I thought these poems rose magnificently to a very, very difficult challenge. There are poems there, the voices, particularly of animals migrating and feeling for home, the ravages of consumerism and its vulgarity, and particularly, as I say, what we would give of ourselves to an alien civilization, that section in particular, driving the poets towards the consideration of the specific, the detail, the hard-edged thinginess of a consideration of the world under threat from growing climate change. So congratulations, all the poets. I think it's very difficult, that terrible word, runner-up, I always object to it. Poetry, literature, art is not a race. It is not comparable to a 100-meter sprint. In each of these sections, I would be hard put to it to say that the runner-up is inferior to the winner. So this is by way of consolation to those who are not marked first in the sections. It has been for me a collegiate process of seeing fellow writers address the very, very difficult matter of taking a huge contested theme and turning it into poetry. Congratulations, all of you. It has been a real pleasure to read your poetry.